I'm Johnny. It's time for mimetic inoculation. William S. Burroughs once said, "There are no innocent bystanders. What were they doing there in the first place?" And that's what I'm going to talk about today. Because there's this thing, and it's called the bystander effect. This is a human mechanism that gives rise to things like Nazism and the ability for somebody to rape a woman in front of 150 witnesses and nobody calls the cops. The bystander effect is the kind of effect that happens when, say, for instance, somebody falls to the ground having a heart attack and everybody thinks to themselves, won't somebody help this man? But nobody does it. Now, if you think you're immune to this effect, you're probably wrong unless you've really thought this one through. Its effect is rather insidious. Strangely enough, the more people there are in an area when somebody is experiencing duress, the less likely they are to receive assistance from the bystanders around them. And it comes down to everybody thinks, I bet you somebody else is more qualified than I. I'm going to let them handle it. Group membership can sometimes help this out. Like, say, for instance, a guy in a hockey jersey has a heart attack. Well, if you're a sports fan that loves the same sportball team as they do, well, then you're more likely to help them. So these tribal affiliations that we all have can sometimes mitigate this effect. It's not something to depend on, certainly. Like, if you're going to have a heart attack, make sure you wear your hockey jersey before the hockey game? Like, no. And doesn't that kind of present some racial undertones? But essentially, as part of a group, even as diffuse a group as, oh, we all happen to be on the same street together, it allows you to slough off that responsibility because of this 30 people, surely one of us will help. And that's the problem, is that no one does. Now, the crazy thing is that I've just given you the solution. That by watching this video and that knowing that all the other humans out there are probably not going to help in a situation such as this, you are now part of the solution. One group of scientists who were studying the bystander effect got a group of individuals together and performed a typical bystander effect study on them. But they said, in the past, when we've studied this, we have found that nobody calls for help. And then they put them through the study, and then lo and behold, all of a sudden, the help rates went up. And it makes sense when you realize that, okay, I can't depend on the group mind to help out in this situation. I have to step up as an individual and solve this problem. And I kind of wonder if we don't think about this as individuals, if we don't think about like what the effect the group mind has on us when we're faced with an emergency situation, will we just fall into the group mind? Like, is the group mind even a thing beyond something to pontificate or experience at 3:03 a.m.? So that's what I mean by mimetic inoculation. Knowing that the group mind will not help in an emergency can prepare you, the individual mind, to actually get help. It's like saying, well, we could never become Nazis here. It's not that Nazis were bad people and we're not bad people. The Nazis thought they were good people doing good things. And that as people, we are just as susceptible to that as they were. And so remember, there are no innocent bystanders. What were they doing there in the first place? And until next time, mental vaccinations are fun. And so that's kind of what I mean about meh, 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 meh.